Welcome, guys, to our Good Camera interview. Today we are with the amazing, fantastic, and so talented Rasmus Hagen from Sweden. Hello, Rasmus.
Hello. Thank you so much.
You are fantastic. Rasmus, first of all, how did you get a start into music? How did you discover that you wanted to be an artist?
I don't know when I discovered when I wanted to be an artist, but I started loving music when I was probably 10 years old, playing guitar mostly.
Very little guy.
Very late? Yeah, very little guy, yeah.
Absolutely. Very little guy.
But I didn't really sing back then. I just played guitar and I wanted to be more like a rock guitarist, I
rock.
Guess. Yeah,
oh,
exactly.
Okay. Fantastic.
That's what I did for a long time. Just wanted to play more guitar, and then it was much later that I discovered that I could actually sing as well. So,
oh, great! How did you get your inspiration to create music?
Well, from the beginning, it was just having idols and looking up to big musicians. And just listening to a lot of music and seeing a lot of big like bands live, watching live music. But then later on, it's like when, yeah.
Which ones? who artists do you listen to?
So many, but in the beginning, as I said, it was more purely like rock and pop rock and stuff like that. So it was a lot of actually Red Hot Chili Peppers back in the day. Yeah, a lot of that stuff. But also at the same time, when I started trying to write more songs, it was more like Cat Stevens and like I guess you would call that like folk or singer-songwriter stuff. So maybe those two. Yeah.
Oh, fantastic! Because you are from Cat Stevens till Red Hot Chili
Peppers. Yeah, it's very very different, and it doesn't sound anything like me. But
yes, but this is fantastic because it gives another perspective.
Yes.
Rasmus, Closer to You is a great song. How does the featuring with Nora Anderson come about?
Well, that was just, I wrote that song back in, I think it was 2019, and I worked with a label back then that actually asked me to record some vocals just as in my studio, just a producer's job, just recording vocals for another song. And then I just borrowed her for my song, because I know I wanted a female vocalist as well. And I asked her to try and sing it. Just, you're here in the studio, just try and sing it. And that's what ended up in the final. I was really happy with it. So it was actually an accident, but a happy accident.
And how do you see the musical scene today?
Sorry?
How do you see the musical scene today?
The musical scene?
Well, yes.
It's so big. It's kind of hard to navigate. I'm trying to stay in my own bubble as much as I can, because you can easily get overwhelmed just going out on TikTok or whatever. It's just so much. So I actually try to get away from the music scene to get inspired more, if that makes sense. It seems a bit counterintuitive, but actually it helps me to not take in so much.
Fantastic. And do you think that record companies and a good manager are still as essential as they were before?
Absolutely not. I think they can be very helpful. They can be helpful, but they, especially in the beginning, if you have no connections or whatever, you can absolutely try and start with a label. But it's just the independent, the ease of being independent is getting easier, and especially when you actually learn how to do the whole craft. As I'm also a producer, I've learned myself because I wanted to produce myself. It's not like I wanted to be a music producer. I just produced my own music, and then I learned how to be good enough at it so I can release my own songs. And I think it's getting easier and easier, and I encourage anyone to do it, actually.
Great. Color With You is your last single. Congratulations, because we love
Thank
it.
you.
We are playing in our program. But I'm a big fan of Wasted Love. It's a brilliant song. I really love it. We usually play love are playing in our program. But which of your songs are you most proud of, and why?
That's a hard one because you gravitate a lot of the time. You gravitate towards you think that you're the proudest of the song that's most popular. If I really dig deep, I don't think that's the case. But I am really proud of Closer to You, because not only because it became popular, but I'm really proud of that song. So I would say, yeah, I would say that song. Otherwise, it would be some songs that maybe follow you as well. I'm really proud of that one.
Rasmus, one of my favorite songs is Fall Out Love. Could you please sing a little bit for us?
Which one? Fall Out of Love? Wow, that
Yeah.
was a long time ago. I haven't sung that in a while. I'm probably forgotten the lyrics.
Oh. Maybe Fraction?
Fraction. Gonna tell you how I feel. No. Let's see a chorus. All I need is a fraction of what your love can give. Just a fraction. A fraction, oh.
Oh,
Okay.
thank you so much.
Thank
We
you.
love your voice. You are totally great,
Thank
Rasmus.
you. Are you
If
only a ballad artist?
you are only into a kind of ballads artist and not
Oh, okay,
into
so ballads.
pop songs, yeah.
I guess it depends on what you compared with, but yeah, I guess ballads is my thing. But I would say I don't know what a ballad is exactly, but it's soft pop. My universe is soft,
Yes.
chill pop.
Yes.
But I guess you could call that ballads as well. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm always a ballad guy because I always prefer the soft songs compared to the up-tempo. I'm always identified with the kind of soft songs and ballads. I always prefer to listen to ballads instead of up-tempo songs, but when up-tempo like Wasted Love, I really love it and
Yeah.
go into that song.
No,
It's amazing.
I enjoy singing on those. I mean,
Yeah.
Wasted Love is it's a collaboration with John Dason, for example.
Yes.
Yes, yes.
I enjoy singing on them, but I don't usually write that kind of music myself when I do my own solo stuff. But I really enjoy singing on them for
This
sure.
collaboration is great.
Thank you.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
Fantastic. Rasmus, do you live in Stockholm? Are you in Stockholm now?
Yes, I live in Stockholm and I have my studio here in Central.
Oh, yeah, fantastic. And any plan for a tour? Have you been on tour in your career in Sweden or in Europe, or any plan for go out on tour?
Yeah, I haven't been in a tour on a tour in Sweden actually, but I was on a tour in Denmark 2 years ago.
Denmark.
Yeah.
Yep, fantastic.
That was really fun. It was a th 3 week long tour, a solo tour with just me and my guitar. So that was really
Fantastic. We'd love to
fun.
be there. And
Yeah.
any plan for a future tour? Have you considered to go out on tour?
It would be so much fun. So much fun.
Yeah.
I will see. You need a lot of you need a great a big team for that, and I do have my Danish booking agent that could help me. But it's a big thing going on tour, and especially the further you get, the harder it is to plan everything. So I'll see. I'm focusing on the studio work for now.
Yeah, we
Great.
know that you spend a lot of time in the studio. You are a great producer and you produce your own music. Have you produced for another artist?
I do produce for other artists. I don't do that as much as I produce my own music, but I do help with I do produce, and I do a lot of like mixing and mastering, very technical stuff, and also some creative producer jobs. But that's not what I'm focusing on. I spend most of my time just writing my own songs and producing my own songs. Yeah.
See, and Rasmus, in your beginnings, you did covers, and today you write your own songs. How does that evolution feel?
It feels great. It was I really enjoyed making the covers because it was so instant, and you got to express yourself, and it helped because in the beginning, when you haven't written anything or have you don't feel as comfortable, it takes a little while to write songs, and therefore you don't get to express yourself. And I got to express myself with the covers, but then when I eventually learned to write my own songs, that felt really nice. Then it's just even more expressive. So it feels really good to just write my own songs now. It's really good.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Rasmus, do you think that artificial intelligence can bring positive content to producer like you?
I think there could be some tools, maybe. I haven't really tried them, but I could be open to try them, but there's a lot of problematic things that needs to be settled first with copyright, stealing just the raw material and mash it up and make it something new, and then who owns the copyright and all that stuff. So I think it's very problematic right now, but yeah, let's see what the future brings. But I'm not using it at the moment.
Rasmus, you are totally great. We love your music. We hope to see you in our program. If you are, do you know Argentina? Have you been in Argentina, in our country?
I've never even been to South America, actually. So
Oh,
yeah, would be great.
you are very welcome here.
Thank you. Would be lovely.
Our program is ready for you if you wanna see, if you wanna come and play and to be in our studio to talk, to play or whatever you want. Our program is yours because we love your music. Our listener are always saying, "Oh, play Wasted Love again." I love you, Colors for You. It's fantastic, great artist.
Nice.
Thank you. Bye bye.
Thank
Thank you.
you. Thank
Bye
you.
bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye. Hello, Good Karma Show. I am Rasmus Hagen. So nice to be talking to you.